I wanted to talk about playing over these changes and doing this kind of major-minor approach to things that I do sometimes. This first example, the chords are A minor, and G minor, and F sharp minor. These chords are they're a little tricky to play over and to make it flow because they're kind of, I don't know what you'd call it, angular or something. But anyways, instead of playing a scale for each chord, like I think of it as all in the key of A, and I just switch between A minor and A major. So for the first two chords, I play on it in A minor. And the last chord I'll switch to A major. And I'll kind of exaggerate the major and minor third so you can hear where it's changing. Concentrate on playing melodies and not worry about changing, you know, scales or keys and modes. Okay, this is the song I'm Buzzed. You have to tune your E string, the low E string, down to D. You get that thing happening. The main thing about this tune is that it's basically based on these two chord shapes, which are this first one. C over F chord, and then the second shape is like this, is like an E minor 9, and the whole tune, yeah, I just kind of move it around. It's a is it's just down on the bottom three strings. So. Open strings a lot, kind of when I improvise, as ways of just letting things ring out. You can do a lot of nice, almost like a harp, I guess. The idea is to never play two notes the same, you know, never. Thank you. fingers a lot when I play, fingers and the pick, but more recently more fingers, but if I do have a pick in my hand, kind of just tuck it, I don't know how I do it, but it's right in there, those first two fingers, just kind of goes in there. So when I'm playing, wide variety of tones out of it. Just switch back to the pick. Here's another example of that major minor kind of approach to playing. The chords are G sharp minor, the F sharp minor, this is kind of an F chord, and for this one I start out in E major for the first two chords. Some of those open strings in there as well. Okay, here's another example of the major minor kind of deal. This is actually a Robin Ford song from his new record, and the song's in D minor. What's the song called? It's called Peace on My Mind. Very pretty song. But it has this great bridge that has a a lot of nice chords in it. And at first it may seem a little hard to play over these, but it's basically just D major and D minor will work over these. But the chords are G minor and E minor, and B flat major 7, and B minor 11, C11, and back to E minor. And then the last chord is, I guess that's an F over E flat, or so I'll just play over that. I'm just switching between D major and D minor.
Thank you.
some pedals I've been using recently that are nice. I should say that I kind of always set the amp kind of a crunchy sound, a little bit dirty. Then I kind of add pedals to that to give more or less gain. But the first pedal is this Maxon. It's an overdrive SD9. That one adds a lot of gain, you know. Turn the guitar down and I get a lot of different degrees of distortion. The next pedal is this Voodoo 1. It's a Roger Mayer pedal. And this is set up more towards for just a clean boost kind of sound. This one also is good for turning your guitar volume down. Gives you a lot of different tones. It's a high impedance one. Cool. The next is a Real McCoy wah-wah pedal. Makes a couple different versions of these. This is a nice box. The stereo, of course, is Arion. I kind of set it to a fast Leslie kind of a thing. And this last box is a Voodoo Vibe, Roger Mayer. And most of the time I leave it on this vibrato setting. It just kind of bends the notes in a nice way. Here's the live setup I've been using. It's small, fits in the car. Not that small, but small enough. This is a Sur head. It's kind of a 100-watt Marshall style head. And this is the 212 cabinet that goes with it. These outer cabinets are just wet cabinets. And what that is through this Lexicon, I have the Lexicon effects coming out only out of these wet cabinets. And how that's done is you need to take a line out of your speaker off your amp. This box was made by Bob Bradshaw. It's very nice. And it converts the speaker level into line level. So you go speaker out of your amp into this, and then back in the cabinet. And then it takes a line out to go into your Lexicon box or whatever you want to use. And then out of the Lexicon into the stereo power amp, which powers these two guys. That way you get all your, you know, your wet sounds or delay and reverbs coming out of separate cabinets. I use a couple different settings. I just kind of manually turn them when I'm playing.